Hello everybody, this is Claudia at Minnie's Girl coming to you again. Today we're going to do pork chops and gravy. I'm only having mashed potatoes and corn, so I'm not going to get into all that because you have videos of potatoes. I might do a little bit on the frozen corn because I know, you know, those of you can't cook, it's something quick and easy for you to learn, and it's great for your kids. You know, we're all about kids and nutrition. I know you hear frying in the background. I'm frying some chicken legs for my husband because you know he doesn't eat pork. But I wanted to do a tutorial on pork chops because I hadn't done it yet, okay? So I'm going to be as quick as I can. Oh, I got to tell you this. This is really cool. Aunt Minnie's is now going East Coast. So now we're not only in Kroger stores down south, we're going to be in the Waldbaum's, Pathmark's, A&P's. On the East Coast. So please go to the freezer and get our products. You're going to love them, okay? And once again, my mom Aunt Minnie is on the box. I always try to show the box before and after the videos because I want you to see how the product looks. And I'm telling you guys, don't forget, ask for it. Ask for it. We have to do that with our products. You know that. So make sure that you ask for it, okay? And believe me, you will not be disappointed. Okay, so we're going to get started with the pork chops. I did not rinse one of them because I wanted to show you. We always rinse our meat off on both sides. Not a lot, but enough to get just the basic things off of it, okay? So I wanted to do that, so we have that here. Now, pork, let me tell you. The rule for pork is we season with red pepper, not black pepper. Black pepper on chicken, black pepper on beef. It can be on turkey, poultry, and we can get in other seasons. I'm not saying that you can't never use red pepper on other meats. I'm just saying that when you season pork, we season it with red pepper. The taste brings it, it enhances the pork meat, and it makes it taste really good. So I want you to understand, we do red pepper with pork. Pork chops, pork roast, we do red pepper, okay? So I want you guys to know that. So we're going to start, we're going to do a little seasoning salt. Now remember, I've been trying to teach you guys about seasoning so you can look and see it. When you see the seasoning on the meat, that's all you need. You don't need to coat the meat with seasoning. As you sprinkle the meat on, you need to see it. That would be more than enough. So we're doing seasoning salt and we're doing red pepper. Really light on the red pepper, you guys, because you know that it's spicy. Cayenne pepper is very spicy. That's C-A-Y-E-N-N-E, and I will put it on the caption so you can see it. And you do both sides, very light, okay? We don't want to overwhelm the meat with salt and with pepper. We want to bring out the flavor of the meat. I think that's so important to know that you need to taste the meat. And every time you feed your kids and you give them something nice, and they taste the flavor of things, I want you to know that you're raising them and you're enhancing them. And as they grow up, they'll remember that. They'll never, ever forget. And I don't think you should just teach your girls how to cook. I think you should teach your boys how to cook too. I have two sons, and both my sons are very good cooks. I wanted them to be able to be on their own. My oldest son is on his own. He takes care of himself, and he can cook. Okay? And he loves to take care of himself, and he loves to know that he can. He kind of holds it over, you know what I mean? But still, it's nice to know, and I feel good about knowing that they can cook. Okay, I'm going to get some wax paper, and what I'm doing is I'm going to spread it out. Now with chicken, what I do with chicken, I have a bag, a Ziploc bag, and I put flour in it halfway, and then that's what I shake my chicken up in, and then I roll it back up and I put it in the freezer. Freezer. That keeps it fresh all the time. And also, while we're on it, when I open up a bag of flour and put it in my canister, I just put a third of it in a canister and put it in the cabinet, and then I put the flour in the refrigerator on the shelf just at the bottom, and I do the cornmeal the same way. That keeps it fresh longer and less chance of it getting bugs, those meal bugs, okay? So that's a tip for the day too. So, but with pork chop, because it's pork, and I don't mix pork with chicken because of my husband, I have flour here in a pan, and that's what I'm going to use. So what I do is lightly on both sides, dust it with flour, and then I shake it off. You see how light it is? You don't coat it with flour, you dust it with flour, okay? On both sides. You want to make sure that it's covered, and then you shake it off. Shake all the excess flour off. See how that looks? Okay, and once again, on both sides. You make sure the flour touches it really well. And when we're done with this flour, we're going to throw it away. Because I don't do a lot of pork, especially when it comes to chops. It just every once in a while I get that yearning, and so I don't really keep the flour. If you do a lot of pork, get a separate bag. If you're worried about mixing your meats, mark it and put it in the freezer. Roll the flour up and put it in the freezer. You see that? Shake all the excess off, lay it down, okay? I have the grease, I'm sorry. Oh, I have the canola oil on the stove right now, medium heat, and it's getting hot. I'm going to show you it because I have a very shallow pan of oil. It's not like when you're cooking chicken, you have a little higher pan of canola oil. So it's very shallow. These chops are about, I'll say a little less than an inch thick. So the oil was the same way, okay? You don't submerge it and fry it hard. You're going to simply brown them on each side. I'm going to go to the stove so I can show you how it looks, and then we'll be back. As you see, I have a very shallow skillet. It's not that much oil in there. You place the chops in there. Even though the oil is hot, you do not drop the chops in there. Do not be afraid of the oil. If you don't disturb it, it won't burn you. So you place it in there, okay? I still think I have a little too much, but that's okay. Not bad. And they'll still come out really well. I really don't like frying it too high. I like my chops to be sort of like this one, not covered. But it's okay, they'll come out nice and brown. I am still frying the chicken. I'll be done in a second with that. But I just wanted you to see how the chops are frying and how they're gonna start, okay? It'll just be a few minutes. I'm gonna turn them over and then we'll start our gravy. As soon as this chicken come out in a few minutes, we're gonna start our gravy, okay?